So, I'm Hidano Nimura from Japan, Shizuoka University. So, that before my research presentation, so I'll briefly introduce our town, Hamamatsu, and our institute, Research Institute of Electronics and Shizuoka University. So we are here in Europe, but Japan is here, very far from the Moldova. It's 11 hours by flight. So this is Japan. So our institute is in Shizuoka Prefecture. Shizuoka Prefecture is between the Tokyo and Kyoto, and almost 250 kilometers from Tokyo. Shizuoka Prefecture is 200 kilometers from Tokyo. And this is a map of the Shizuoka Prefecture. So our university is the Shizuoka University. It's, Shizuoka University is one of the national universities in Japan. So we have two campuses, Shizuoka campus and the Hamamatsu campus. Our institute is in Hamamatsu campus, so west side of the Shizuoka prefecture. So Shizuoka prefecture is famous for the Mount Fuji. Mount Fuji is the highest mountains in Japan. So this is Mount Fuji, it's the highest mountain in Japan, almost 3,000 meters. So this is the campus of our Hamamatsu campus. So our institute is here. It's almost so near center of the city. So Hamamatsu is known as a very industrial city. So several big companies are concentrated in Hamamatsu. It's Yamaha Motor and Suzuki, so automobile company, and Honda, and also music instrument company, Yamaha, Kawai, Roland is in Hamamatsu. And Toyota is originated from Hamamatsu, but moved to the Toyota city now, but near to Hamamatsu. And also, it's very famous detector company, so Hamamatsu Photonics. So anyone calls Hamamatsu, it's so in Hamamatsu. So many high technology companies, especially motor companies, music instrument company, and famous photo detector company are in Hamamatsu. So this is the downtown is in Hamamatsu. This is a station. The population is almost 800,000. It's the largest city in Shizuoka Prefecture. So this is the Hamamatsu capital. So Hamamatsu is known as the success of the town. So because the two famous shogun who unified Japan, so they lived in Hamamatsu in the almost 450 years ago. So one is Toyotomi Hideyoshi, who lived in Hamamatsu, and then later he moved to the Osaka and built the Osaka Castle. And the other one is the first shogun, Tokugawa Ieyasu, so who opened the Edo period. And he lived in Hamamatsu, and he built the Hamamatsu Castle, and later he moved to Tokyo, and built the Tokyo Edo Castle. So our institute is known as a birthplace of the all-electric television system. So this is our institute, Research Institute of Electronics. So the late Professor Kenjiro Takayanagi invented the all-electric television system. So he displayed so Japanese character. This is the alphabet of the Japanese. He displayed the Japanese character, modified brown tube in 1926. At that time, so he used the mechanical television camera, so like this Nippo disc. He accomplished all electric television system in 1936. At that time, he invented the electric television camera system, so iconoscope camera system, and also CRT, cathode ray tube, so display. So since then, our institute is designated as a center of excellence in the imaging field. So that we, Shizuoka University won the IEEE Milestone Award. So IEEE Milestone Award is known as the Nobel Prize and the World Heritage in the Electrical Technology. So in development of the electric television in 2009. So Japan won the 34 IEEE Milestone Awards, but only 5 universities won the award. Our university is one of this university. Okay, so that we accepted so the many foreign students, so the many foreign students from the Europe, so the studies in our institute. And also I'm one member of the Academy of Science of the Moldova. I visited the Moldova almost every year. Okay, so I talk about my research. Okay, so the title is Fabrication of Highly Aligned CNT Sheets and the Application to Strain Sensors. This work is collaborated with the Yamaha Corporation Music Instrument Company. So this is outline my work. So our group want to develop a practical application using the CNT, carbon nanotube. So carbon nanotube, attracts much interest but the real practical device, so using the carbon nanotube is not so realized yet. So our group want to develop the real practical applications using the carbon nanotube. And electric data of the precise human motions are strongly required in the computer graphic, robotics, healthcare, and so on. The developing flexible sensors collecting the data of the human motions are very important in a computer graphic, robotics, healthcare, and so on. So our group has fabricated the drawable carbon nanotube, so very unique carbon nanotube. So we applied such a drawable carbon nanotube to the strain sensors. So I'll talk about the fabrication and the characteristics of the drawable carbon nanotube and the application to the strain sensor. And also, our group is now applying such a strain sensors to the computer graphics, so virtual reality and medical engineering field, and so on. So that I briefly talk about this application, these applications. So you know the carbon nanotube. The carbon nanotube is discovered by the Iijima. Dr. Iijima is 1991. The carbon nanotube is a cylindrical nanostructure of the graphene sheet. Carbon nanotube has an excellent property. So large aspect ratio, so light weight, and high mechanical strength, and high electrical conductivity, so good heat conductance. But these are the theoretical values. In the real carbon nanotube doesn't have such the excellent characteristics. That's a problem to apply the carbon nanotube to the real practical devices. The many potential applications are expected in carbon nanotube, so energy storage field and water purification, transportation and automobile and electronics and sports gears. So, however, real device is not realized yet. So this is a method in our grow the carbon nanotube. Our method is a chloride meditated chemical vapor deposition. So we put the quartz tube and iron chloride catalyst inside the quartz tube, and we evacuate this the furnace quartz tube in the pressure at the pressure less than 1.1 Pascal. And we heating up this quartz tube and 820 centigrade, so it's maintaining the vacuum. And we flow the acetylene gas, this one. So our method is very, very so simple one. So the carbon nanotube so grows on the iron so catalyst in the bottom so grows. And ultra long multi-wall carbon nanotube grows so in this method. So future of our grown technique is like this. So this method requires no pre-process for deposition of the catalyst, no metal film. So conventional of the carbon nanotube. So first is the metal catalyst is so the deposited on the substrate, and then carbon nanotube grows. But our method does not require the pre-process for the deposition of the catalyst. Our method is a one-step CVD method. So loading a substrate, evacuating and heating up, then feeding the acetylene. This is a very simple method. So very easy and high reproducible method. So aligned ultra long multi-wall carbon nanotube growth in this method. Growth site new creation multi-wall carbon nanotube growth are done by one step chloride meditated CVD. This is a picture of our grown, our fabricated, our carbon nanotube. So our carbon nanotube so is grown on the quartz substrate, insulator substrate. And our carbon nanotube so grown on the each face, so top and bottom, and right side and the left side, and front and back. So this is a scanning electron microscope image. So very high density, aligned high density multi-wall carbon nanotube is grown on a quartz substrate. This is a TEM image, transmission electron microscope image. Very, very so the multi-wall. This picture shows the multi-wall carbon nanotube is grown so in our method. And top surface is a very, very flat. So this means length of the multi-wall carbon nanotube is very so the uniform so throughout the substrate. Our method is a very rapid growth method. So typically 21 millimeter carbon nanotube is grown for the 20 minutes. So the high density aligned multi-wall carbon nanotube is sort of grown on the quartz substrate. So this figure shows this picture shows the longest carbon nanotube so far. So the 3.5 nanometer long carbon nanotube is so grown on the substrate. So the unique property of our carbon nanotube is drawable. So we put the carbon nanotube array sample, and then pull off the carbon nanotube. So it's carbon nanotube wave is easily fabricated. So the carbon nanotube wave over the 6 meters, so without twisting, is obtained. Not work. So carbon nanotubes is constantly, carbon nanotube wave is constantly so obtained. So using the, so this method. So the okay. So carbon nanotube is constant. Web is constantly fabricated. So this is one of the unique properties. Okay. So why is our carbon nanotube is drawable? So carbon nanotube wave consists of many, many short carbon nanotube. In our case, it's 2 millimeter. So the carbon nanotube is connected each other. So our carbon nanotube, the surface of our carbon nanotube is very clean and has a very few amorphous layers. So the short carbon nanotube fibers are connected end to end by van der Waals force with a small overlap. This is a small overlap. So the small carbon nanotube, 2 millimeter carbon nanotube is connected. And consists of the long, finally, so the carbon nanotube forms a long, so the wire and rope. Wave. So this is the keys of the drawability. So the first one is the distance is very important. So distance between the each carbon nanotube should be close enough to touch with each other in arrays. So the control of the density of the growth site is important. And the surface. A carbon nanotube surface should be clean from the amorphous carbon to maximize van der Waals force between the carbon nanotubes. So that decreasing the deposition of the amorphous layer is important. So the surface clean is very important. And also, scanning a microscope images of two types of the carbon nanotube. This is our carbon nanotube. This is a conventional carbon nanotube. So our carbon nanotube is super alignment, very straight, and very close to the carbon nanotube, so each other. And very, very high density, larger than the 10 to the 9 square centimeter. And in this case, so it shows the high drawability. In the conventional carbon nanotube, so the conventional carbon nanotube is low density and so tangled fibers. In this case, so the this carbon nanotube does not show the non-drawability. Does not show a drawability. So using such the carbon nanotube arrays, we make the several so the product, so the CNT tape and CNT ends and CNT arrays and CNT sheet, 100% carbon nanotube sheet. So this is this figure shows how to spin the carbon nanotube to a yarn. So that this spindle is so rotated and then moved to the backside. And then we fabricated the carbon nanotube yarn like this. So this carbon nanotube yarn does not contain any chemical, so binder material. That's 100% carbon nanotube. And this is one of the electrical properties. It's a carbon nanotube fiber, so the with a diameter of the 0.1 millimeter. So in this case, the electrical resistivity is 8 times 10 to the minus 4 ohm centimeter. It's very similar to the, so the tungsten wire. Not so high. That is the problem. And also, this is a mechanical property. So we apply the tensile strength to the carbon nanotube fiber, so the diameter is 0.1 millimeter. At the certain strain, carbon nanotube, so the break. So the using such characteristic, we estimated the tensile strength is in this case, so 0.75 gigapascal. In the theoretical value, it's electric conductivity is 1 gigaampere per square centimeter, 1,000 times larger than copper, and tensile strength is 150 gigapascal. But in the real value, is tensile strength is 0.575 gigapascal, and resistivity is relatively large. That's the problem with the carbon nanotube. One of the big construction company, Obayashi Gumi in Japan, so they address the space elevator is the project of the space elevator is started in 2025. They start to build the space elevator. Space elevator is so like this and. The space station is fabricated. It's 36,000 kilometer high the earth. And then the Obashikumi believed our carbon nanotube, so the young carbon nanotube rope is very suitable for the this space elevator. And Obashikumi said he accomplished the space elevator project he accomplished to build the space elevator 2050. So the Obashikumi said to us, so the 2050, and so anybody so can go to the space by using this elevator system, so using the carbon nanotube. So, but I don't believe it. Obashikumi believe, but I don't believe it. So, this is so the highly aligned CNT seat. Okay, this is a 100% CNT seat, so CNT paper. Okay, so the it's a very anisotropic properties. So, the electric conductivity is low. So, this side is carbon nanotube. Carbon nanotube is aligned. So this direction. So the conductivity of the this direction is so lower than this. So the vertical direction. Okay, this figure shows how to make the carbon nanotube seat. So this is a carbon nanotube array. A carbon nanotube wave is so the pull of this carbon nanotube. So array and so move this carbon nanotube array. So the we wind the carbon nanotube with a rotated drum and then while the sliding this carbon nanotube array. So that we make and then and we cut. We cut this, and so that we make the carbon nanotube sheet. So, using the carbon nanotube sheet, so we fabricated the CNT tape, so like this. So by cutting the carbon nanotube sheet, and then we fabricated the carbon nanotube strain sensor. This is a cross-section view of the carbon nanotube strain sensor. We put the carbon nanotube tape on the polycarbonate urethane resin PCU substrate, and then we adhere the carbon nanotube tape on the PCU using the pad electrode and also the conductive soda paste. This direction is the aligned direction. So we pull off, we stretch the carbon nanotube tape, carbon nanotube strain sensor, the resistivity increase. So we release the strain, so the resistivity recover to the initial value. This is a carbon nanotube strain sensor. So we applied the strain to the carbon nanotube strain sensor, so resistance so increase. This characteristic shows a very linear properties. So the resistance includes the linearly proportional to the applied strain. And then release the strain, the resistance recovers the initial value. So why the resistance so includes when we apply the strain to the carbon nanotube sensors. So these pictures are the optical microscope images. So as we include the strain, the small gaps appears on the surface of the carbon nanotube sheet. So these small gaps so includes the resistance. So the when we release the strain, so gap is disappear and then recover to this initial surface, and then the resistance return to the initial value. Okay, this is a dynamic strain resistance characteristic. It's at 3 Hz. The blue one is the strain, applied strain, and red one is the resistance. At the resistance variations closely correspond to the temporal change in the applied strain. So the applied strain, so the resistance includes. Okay, in this case, 30 Hz. So the until the frequency of 30 Hz, the sensor shows an excellent rapid response. So the includes the strain, and the resistance also strain. Resistance also includes. This is one of the commercialized CNT strain sensor. Yamaha commercialized this CNT strain sensor. This is a CNT strain sensor. This is a stretchable textile, and this is a wireless transmitter using so the Bluetooth. So the this wireless transmitter so sends the data of the strain data to the our cellular phones, iPhone or cellular phones. And also we develop the data group for collecting the data from the fine finger motions. So these are the carbon nanotube so strain sensor. This carbon nanotube strain sensor detected the angle of the finger motions and collected the data. Okay, this is a carbon nanotube globe. So carbon nanotube globe, so the collected the data of the angle of the fingers. So then we send these data to the computer graphics. The computer graphics shows perfectly, so that reproduce the the motion of the, so the fingers. So typically, motion capture method is there is a motion capture. So many people use motion capture so the method, but the motion capture so does not correct the finger motions. So the body motions it's easily. Obtained, but the finger motion is very difficult. Obtain the finger motion is very, very difficult. Okay, this is a music playing, a piano playing. So demonstration of the collecting the data of the finger motion in the playing the piano. Okay, so the, we collaborate with the Yamaha. Yamaha is a music instrument company. So that they want to collect the data. It's a professional. What's the difference between the professional pianist and the amateur pianist? This is a signal. It's a finger joint angle. Signal of the data of the finger joint angle. This is a professional piano player. So this is a lateral axis is the time, and vertical axis is the and the magnitude of the finger angle. It's in the professional piano player, the finger angle of the finger is very, very smooth in the professional piano player. But in the on the other hand, in the amateur piano player, the so angle is sort of very large. Not smooth. So the Yamaha collect want to collect such a sort of data. And Yamaha use such a sort of data for the practicing such a piano. And also such strain sensor is incorporated in the solar cross. In this case, such cross so collecting the motion data so for the human body. Okay, this is one of the image video. This is a carbon nanotube strain sensor. Light and stretchable. So, apply the stress and carbon resistivity so it grows. This is data growth. The motion of the body is also the it's a conventional way. It's a computer graphics. So conventional motion capture does not correct the finger motions. So only our data globe collects the finger motions. This applies to the virtual reality. So they grasp some gears, some parts of the machine, and then move. Okay, and finally, so I briefly talk about the application of the data to the medical engineering. So this is the object is a rehabilitation for the recovery of the finger functions for the persons with a paralysis. So first, for the normal persons, so we collect the data. The data group collects the it's right hand and left hand, and left hand we put the multi-part electrode. So the first, the data group collects the electric data from the normal finger motions in the right hand, and then electric stimulus is applied to the multi-part electrodes. So in this case, fingers spontaneously moved. So we determine the waveform of the electric stimulus so that the data of the left hand coincides with the data of the right hand. So that we apply the electric stimulus so that fingers spontaneous motions. And then for the persons whose left hand is paralyzed, it's also disabled. The left hand side does not move. Okay? So in the such people. So we apply the waveform to the electrical stimulus determined in the number three. So this one, so we determine the waveform with the electric stimulus. And then we apply such the waveform to the multi-part electrode. Okay, so the fingers, moved spontaneous, but not, the fingers does not move, it's normal. But such persons, the left hand side does not move so much. So, but, in this case, does not move, but the data flow, so check if the fingers moved in the same way as the movement of the right hand in the number three. So that we practice such people. So if we continue to this rehabilitation, the neuron, inside the brain, connects again. and fingers functions are expected to the recover. So the, now we try to such kind of the rehabilitation to the people who whose left hand side or the right hand side is does not move so the not so much. Yeah, it's some okay, such kind of disabled. Okay, let me summarize my talk. So the our group has fabricated the drawable CMT by one-step CVD method. So the our group has developed the strain sensors using the CNT wave for the human motion detections. So we have confirmed that the developed strain sensors can precisely collect the data of the human motion. So the we applied so the strain sensors to the computer graphics and virtual reality or the and engineering. Medical engineering so field. So thank you very much for your kind attention. Now, Professor Aoki Sensei is so continue to present his work.
Okay, so let's move to my topics. So my topics is a little bit different from Mimura Sensei's topics. So my lecture is X-ray detection and imaging. So I'm Tora Aoki from a research institute of electronics, Shizuoka University, same institute from Mimura Sensei. So I belong to the research institute of electronics and the graduate school of medical photonics. And this is my spin-off company of the venture company of the Unseen. So I'm from Japan, but I came from Chernobyl, Ukraine, so by taxi. So just 1 hour before, I wear my company's wear, so Unseen. So maybe it is good for me. So I will put off. Okay. Maybe you know X-ray imaging. X-ray imaging. So this kind of X-ray imaging is very famous. So X-ray computed tomography, so cross-section imaging, rentgen, and so on. This kind of the medical applications. Some application is space science. So for funding generation of space and so on. So and this is also one of the important application, the security and monitoring and so on. So today I want to lecture so many things. So but so please so many things. So but so I teach so several so important things. So this is X-ray detector, construction of the X-ray detectors. So this figure shows the conventional X-ray imaging detector. So in the hospital, still so they use X-ray film. So and recently so they use imaging plate. It's just like a film. So but so when so rentgen taken here, so and after then so in the film, so we need the chemical treatment. So but IP imaging plate is can read out so by using a laser. So but recently so this kind of digital rentgen system is this is a scintillator material. Scintillator is when X-ray photons come into the scintillators, so this scintillator generates visible light like this gray light. So we can detect the this X-ray signal by using the conventional CMOS or CCD imaging sensor like this. However, maybe you know X-ray photon is penetrated all of the material. It's a very important properties. So, compared with the solar PV bride. So therefore, so, we need thick scintillator material for stopping the X-ray photons. So, in the conventional CMOS or CCD images, so inside of this here, so this sensitive layer of this photon, visible photons, about 1 micrometer. So, but in this case, usually we use a 1 millimeter to 1 centimeter. So, very thick. Therefore, so, X-ray photon generates so visible photons like this. So, but this visible photon is so, we what expected so to hear. So, but so many scattering is occurred like this. So, therefore, so, we studied about semiconductor type X-ray image. Almost property the same. X-ray photon is coming to here. In this case, scintillator materials generate a visible photon. So in semiconductor case, this X-ray photons generate the electron. So, but by using the electron field, so this is semiconductors, this is electrode. So we can apply high bias voltage like this. So in that case, so we can obtain the high electric field in this material. Therefore, so electrons move to directly so like this. So we can get more sharp image from so this detectors. I will show the so example pictures so, later. So and we can use this kind of photon counting techniques so in this sensors. So I will show the so details so later. So and please remember one of the so important phenomena science is so nanovision science. So our institute, so Professor Mimura already introduced our institute. So our institute is served by the result of the so Professor Kenjiro Takayanagi's result, who invented the so all electric TV system. Therefore, so we have a long history of the so imaging engineering. So and then so recently so nanotechnology is developed and many famous professors coming to our institute. So we make so nanovision science, so new image science. So it is a so conventional imaging sensor. So many pixels are here. So but so in here so dark so small amount of small number of the so photons coming to the so frame time. So dark. So in here, so much number of so photons come here. So this kind of treatment is a corrective stereo treatment of photons and electrons is a so conventional type. So but our new idea is so individual photon and electric handling. So in nanometer region. So please remember so this fantasy so sciences. So and. More please remember more one very simple phenomena. Photon counting in the X-ray sensor semiconductors. So this is the so, structure of the so 1 pixel of the X-ray detectors. So this is bias voltage, so this is output signal. So when X-ray photon come into this semiconductor, so catch it here. So this X-ray photon generated this kinds of many electron hole pair in here. So because so visible light photon has a so almost same energy of the band gap. So 1 electron or 2 electrons, 3 electrons. Therefore, so 1 photon generates 1 electron hole pair. So maybe you know. So for visible light. But so for X-ray photon has a very, very high energy. 1 electron or 2 electron is the visible light. So X-ray photon is so, for example here, so 100 kilo electron volt. So in that case, so in the cadmium telluride, so cadmium telluride generates so 23,000 of the whole electron pair. Therefore, so a little bit different, but so when so X-ray photon is coming to here, so this photon generates so many electron photon pairs. So and interesting is here. So a number of electron hole pair is related with the so photon energy. photon energy means so wavelength is so wavelength and energy is so almost same. So X-ray photon energy. So if we can count the so number of the number of the hole or so electron pairs, so we can know the each energy of the X-ray photon. This is a photon counting technique. So in X-ray region, not we can know the not only the number of the X-ray photons, but also we can know the so each photon energy by using this technique. So for example here, so at the first time, so we get so this kind of so number of the electrons here, so middle energy. So and the next one is no. So next is so high, middle, low, so and then. So by summation of the so in the frame time. So usually so this kind of the, so imaging sensor has a so frame time. So each frame time so 10 milliseconds, 30 milliseconds and so on. So we can get this kind of histogram from so this data. So this histogram is so equal is so energy spectrum of the so incident X-ray photons, not only photon, photons. So we can get this kind of energy spectrum from so this detector. So if so we integrated the so counting circuit in the each pixel, we can get the so full spectrum detection X-ray image. So we can make. So our laboratory, so we try to make so this kind of so detectors. So this is so magnetic wavelength table. So visible light here. So X-ray and gamma is a little bit far from so here. So but so X-ray gamma ray, so it has a so very wide wavelength. It means that so very wide X-ray photon energy regions like this. So but so maybe you know the almost rentgen picture has a so monochromatic, so white and black image. So because so the film cannot distinguish so this kind of energy. There are so X-ray photons has a so this kind of information, but we ignore so this kind of information for image. But if we can get the so X-ray energy information like this, this is the energy, this is the intensity. So and put this kind of color, so we can make a so interesting so picture in X-ray region. So therefore, so we try to make a so this kind of photon counting X-ray imaging sensor. So a little bit difficult so in this slide. So generator means X-ray tube generate this kind of so energy spectrum. This is a wavelength, but so this kind of energy spectrum. So therefore, so we call the so X-ray tube X-ray from the X-ray tube is a so white X-ray, so like this kind of spectrum. So therefore, so but so attenuation mechanism is like here. So if we use this kind of white X-ray, so we have to use a so energy distinguished type X-ray imager is needed for that. For example, this kind of thesis. This means so small iron is here, thin iron is here. So we can check so how thick iron is. So this kind of the technique is so long time. So just images, not correct data. So and more interesting is here. So usually so film and so another kind of scintillator device. So we use so integration means so integration time for the so frame rate. So in that case, so this blue the green line is the so original signal from the so detectors. So but so this kind of noise is available. So our summation data libraries. So this is a so theoretical data. So but here is a noise. So this is a so make a so low contrast high noise images from here. So but by using the photon counting, so if so we have this kind of so noise analog noises here. So but we can count only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 so with by threshold. So we can get noise less imaging. So it is very interesting. So later so I will show you. So, for making so this kind of detector, so we use so this kind of techniques. So very special technique for cadmium telluride is very important. Complex material. It is not so easy to so process in the so same process, semiconductor process like a silicon. Therefore, so we develop this kind of so detectors. My collaborators in the Ukraine, so we get this kind of detector. So, blocking layer, this is a so, cadmium telluride. So, we make a so, PNI junction and so, PI junctions here. So, PIN structure of the cadmium telluride diode. So, this is a very good blocking layer. So, we can get very low noise, low current. So, and we get so, this kind of good energy spectrum. So, cesium, so cobalt, and americium is radioisotopes. So we can get some very good energy spectrum from here. So another viewpoint. So this is a typical scintillator type detectors. So taking a printed penetration image of the printed circuit. So which maybe so which picture is so better? Same position. So, but contrast is very different. So, this is a scintillator type detector. So, this is a photon counting type detector. So, this kind of the structure, photon counting detector is very useful. So, we can get very high contrasted low noise images. So, by using photon counting techniques. So, and another point. So, this is a CT, computed tomography image of the tooth. So the typical computed tomography, you use 120 kilovolt of the accelerated voltage of the X-ray tube. So this value, maybe you are not familiar. So 20 milliampere second. So how long time so expose the X-ray tube with X-ray tube current? So it means that X-ray exposure intensity is almost exponential. So typical CT system, so if we use 200 milliampere seconds, but picture is not so good. So but so by using cadmium telluride, so in this case circuit is the current MOS, but we can reduce the 4 times reduce of the X-ray and very good image. So and then by using the photon counting, so this is 200, this is about 1 milliampere. So, but we can get so this kind of good images. This is so this powerful technique, evidence of the powerful technique of the photon counting techniques. However, photon counting technique is not so new technique. So maybe so in the 80s, so some detectors. So for checking so radioisotope and so on. So or so maybe you use so EDS energy distribution so spectroscopy in the SEM.
Yeah,
EDS. No?
Energy dispersion.
Yes. This photon counting technique is almost same phenomenon. So but the counting rate is very low. Maximum counting rate. Because so if so two photons come into the same center in detector, we cannot understand so energy. We can know the summation of the so electron number. So but so we can distinguish how many photons, how energy, so we can. Therefore, so high speed detection and high speed signal processing is required. So usually conventional so SEM system, so usually so less than 1 kilo count per second. So this is a commercial so highest so photon counting detector system. So for checking so sometimes in the nuclear plant and so on. So 20 kilo CPS. But if so this kind of detector is so using it in the practical, so at least 1 mega CPS, very high, is so needed. Therefore, so, we try to make so this kind of high speed. This is so original. We develop the so from so material, cadmium material device semiconductor device structures. So we check many kind of analysis, many kind of so result. So we optimize so cadmium telluride structure and electronics and computer software. So total system is very important in here. So by today, so I skip the so new algorithm of the detection. So but we make a so new algorithm of the so signal processing and so device structure. So by using so these techniques, so this is a so low means so RI, radioisotope only. So in this case, so our laboratory permitted only very small amalgam is only. So here is amalgam, so barium, so cesium, so very slow count. Less than so 10 kilo CPS count per second. So by using so X-ray tube is so acceleration to so number of count. Here is X-ray. So in this case, so I'm sorry, so here, so about 1 mega CPS. So we can get good energy spectrum from so this area. So all of the so digital system so achieve so this kind of good result. So. And so, by using this technique, so this is a so chart of the so X-ray checking chart, so made by Reed. So this IP film is widely used so in the hospital, so we can get this kind of images. So cadmium telluride a little bit so noisy, so but we can get high quality, high contrasted images here. So this line is so precisely said. So scintillator and CCD system is so widely used so cheap detector, imaging detector, so but not so good. So this is a so real detector, so this is a line profile of the cadmium telluride, so another kind of the detector. This detector has a so very good, so half means so 4 times or less smaller picture, similar pixel. So therefore, so good results is get. So but almost same, so 100 micron pitch and 48 micron pitch, almost same data, so we can get. This kind of, so this is so cadmium telluride by UV. This is so data from so MTF modulation transfer function. So we get this kind of data. So by using so energy information of X-ray photon, so it's difficult to distinguish so in this LCD projector. So This is a so small fish, head of the small fish. So this picture is taken by low energy. We take so all of these, so we use so low energy information for making this image. So we can get the so very this here, maybe this kind of here contrasting here. So and this kind of here. So by using high energy, we can get easily so hard bone like this. So by synthesis, some calculations are needed. By synthesis of so two images, we can get so this kind of image. So a bone and so some so small contrast in here. So this is so I'm sorry. So this is Japanese. Near the so eyes. So this mouth and cover and bone is here. So this picture is almost the same as the so, previous pictures. In the very low dose conditions, so we can get good picture. So and this is so attenuation coefficient table versus the, so photon energy. Photon means X-ray photon energy. So this line, this dash line is so silicon. So 10 kilo electron volt is so 100 centimeter per centimeter. So silicon is like this curve. So low energy, so silicon is good. So but high energy, almost X-ray is penetrated. So for iron, so like this curve. So cadmium telluride like this. So every material, so cadmium telluride sometimes so plastic, sometimes so stainless steel, so aluminum. So every material has a different curve, different this energy attenuation curve. So by using so this curve, we can get this kind of images. So here is a so we put the plate on the, so, this aluminum plate. So zinc, aluminum, gold, platinum, so. So by using the, so, the cup fitting technique, so we can get, the, so in this case zinc, so in this case aluminum, so aluminum frame is, or geranium frame is, so almost so. This is not perfect, so but we can emphasize some materials. In this case, so simple element of the sort of metal. So another case is here. So have you came to Japan? No. So Japanese children also very famous so Japanese sweets. So this is a small chocolate. So many children get so and so go to small shop and sweet. So this is a small caramel from Japan. So but here is a so dangerous plastic bag. So, but so by using so conventional penetration imaging, X-ray rendering, so we can get only this kind of image. It is very difficult to so distinguish this dangerous material. So this is a so computed tomography image. So we can get a cross-sectional image of the, so this material. So we can get this kind of shape, but it's difficult. So, but by using so energy information, we can calculate it from so this is almost a density mapping. So we can distinguish two images. So one is so atomic number, effective atomic number. So it means so average, almost the average atomic number is here. So here is electron density mapping. So almost same atomic number. So this material has so. So but so by using so this picture, so we can obtain that so here it's a high electron density. So it's so. Dangerous materials. So we try to so many kinds of dangerous material and so safety materials. So but so sometimes so Japanese government get angry. So I showed so this detailed data. So by using this system, so dangerous materials is here. So another material is not dangerous. So in the liquid, so dangerous materials, so it is a very powerful technique for a security checkpoint inside of the airport. Not the so your back, so inside back checking system, so in United States and so Japan uses so this kind of system. This is another means so this is so chicken wing. Chicken bone. So we put this blue color for the, so, this meat, and so bone is here. So we can find so, some so air so, in the bone, so like this. So this is one of the examples of the morph. So this is so energy, different energy, so we can get this kind of different pictures. But so it's difficult to find so very special property from this picture. So if you find so this picture is so this is a special point. So please come to my laboratory. So instead of so I put those are my students. So please teach me so how different. So almost same. So contrast a little bit. So we have to calculate also so these pictures. So sometimes we use these pictures. Sometimes we use so original data, so but different energy regions. So we can get the so interesting data so from so here. So this is so expand so in this very low condition, so we can get the good. So in this case, so we prepare the so acrylic fandom. Acrylic is the very almost the same so property, X-ray penetration property of the, so, our body, human body. So 50 millimeter, almost so here. So we put the so, water. Water is here. So here is the, so iodine. Iodine is the, so sometimes the, so what's that? Sometimes so doctor uses so this material so for inside of the, so our blood tube. So by using photon counting techniques, we can reduce the so X-ray tube current to of about so thousand times lesson. So but we can get almost same quality. So but so by using so conventional mode. So but material is cadmium telluride. Difference is signal process. So we can get so reduce so some noise is here. So we can understand so any pictures from so this kind. This kind of technique, sometimes so this kind of interesting science. So this is so semiconductor physics. So here is so crystal. So gallium antimony, so it's here. So this is so feed gallium antimony. So here is so indium antimony. So and here is so gallium antimony. So by increasing the temperature, so this gallium indium antimony is diffused into the so. Seed of the gallium antimony. So Professor Hayakawa so in my institute, so he tried to make us this kind of many so experiment. So and so he analysis so very interesting so result from. So totally so I want to summarize so like this. So but after here so please keep very easy. So I will show you so some pictures. So this is our cadmium telluride photon counting detector. So here is the so scintillator material. So can you understand the difference? So it is not so here is the so little. It is not so good for so human eyes. So, but recently, so we put this data so into the so computer, so deep learning and so AI system. So, for checking the so this kind of so material, so many messages coming. So, in that case, so this kind of high contrasted high resolution image is very important. This is so another case. It's a very small engine. So. Maybe different. So, but so it is good or not is so very another problem. So, this is a camera. Big camera. Maybe Nikon camera. So, we can find so some sort of differences in this case. So, so this is so treatment. So, yeah. In the dental clinic, doctor put so some stainless wire, maybe make a small hole and so put it like this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, correct.
How we express? But so it is first time, so real time imaging. So because so this is so doctor's hand, because in this case very low dose, so 100 micron sievert per hour. So therefore, the doctor can, so low dose is here. Here is so more smaller, so maybe 10 micron sievert per hour. So doctor can put this. All of the doctor, only so his experience, maybe here. So but so by using so our technique, so this kind of treatment, so here so is so only 100 micron so diameter, so it is not so easy. So our detector has a very high frame rate, 100 frame per second. So this movie is so changed to the, so maybe 30 or so 15, so for reducing the so file size. So but real image is so we can get more high. In this case, 20 frames per second, so could this be it? So this is so little bit difficult and so new topics. So in next class, I will show. So this is very just some. So this is so electric bulb. So vacuum, not electric bulb. So in the car, for the car, so some pencil, stapler, camera, big camera, small camera. Small. But this is so smartphone. Maybe so here is so iPhone 6 or 7. So here is so how it's little difference. So this is so なんだったかな、リモートコマンダーの so TV. So this is so plug ignition plug in the so engine. So conventional technique, it is very difficult to take so this kind of structure. So almost X-ray is very high density materials they use. So almostly so X-ray is so stopped in the here. So it's very difficult to make so this kind of contrast. これファイナリーだな。ファイナリー、so I will show you some interesting devices. Do you know so Nixie tube? Not LED.Maybe Bimura 先生 and Kimura 先生 knows so this kind of tube. So this kind of tube. So if your university has a very old so electrical voltmeter and so on, this kind of device, not LED, so this kind of device. So this is one of the vacuum tube. So here is so base electrode. So this is so computed tomography image. So and here is a grid. So 230.2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, so this kind. So I move to the so in this movie, so I move to the so this viewpoint from so bottom to up. So you can see the so here. So please see. This is the bottom. So maybe you can find some.Maybe it is not so important information. So because we can see that so this grid structure from so outside of the this Nixie tube. So but so one of the demonstrations so our CT system. So our CT system has a very thin cross section layer. So usually so medical CT has a so 1 millimeter of the so thickness of the so thickness slice thickness.So in this case, so we have so maybe in this optics, so maybe 500 micrometer. So I want to show the, so this high resolution of so this kind of slice. So but not so important information. So but by using so a new technique for the X-ray detection and imaging, so we can get so this kind of interesting result, and we can apply the so new.Medical industrial security, so many many wide applications. So I believe. Okay, thank you very much.
Yes, I ask you. Great presentation, really. I was gonna ask you about the noise threshold. So when you showed the photo noise threshold,
yes,
and I wanted to ask if that's a linear function.Or what are you using as a function for a noise threshold? Because obviously, if you use just a linear function, it's a different. Maybe you're using AI or that's the question basically.
So I said, so noiseless means so no touch. Of course, so we put the so noise threshold energy threshold so above the analog noise and so on. So we can.Cut so this kind of noise.
But is it linear? So
yeah.
Is it just so is it just a range, or is it maybe I don't know a function of some sort? And I don't know.
So linear means so linear. So however, so this noise here. Just a moment. This is a very good question. So this is so noise so we can cut. So but so original signal. So this signal includes so this noise.
But that creates contrast,
yes,
right?
Yes.
That's the reason why you get contrast.
Yes.
So if so for example, if we say, I don't know, I'm just giving out a proposition because I know for example in computer imaging they use they use machine learning functions, so they don't use a linear function.
Yeah.
Basically, they use a complex function.
Yes. So,
So, it's good.
So, therefore, so, we have to reduce the noise in the circuit. We have to reduce. So, finally, so this kind of noise is sometimes so it makes us so error in the so for human body. So it is a good problem. It's so very good patients. Thank you.
I have another question.
Yes.
What kind of denoising do you use for the image processing?
Yeah. What kind of noise?
Yeah, denoising filters. Like, do you know about BM3D?
In this case,
yeah.
Images. So in the photon counting technology, so we don't use so any filters.
Any filters,
yes.
Like
yeah.
Nothing for image processing.
Yes.
Okay.
They use two images because they use two free images when you do, and you remove the noise with just merging three images. That's
so. If so, some doctor wants to so reduce so some kind of noise, so we apply to use so some kind of filter. So but so this data so we don't use so any so noise reducing technique so on the so image. So, not only so my question, so Mimura sensei, for Mimura sensei, carbon number two, so you can ask. No questions? So, very interesting, carbon number two, no? So, if you have a question, so please don't hesitate, so please ask.